When I was stuck in the addictive cycle, I would find myself after relapse feeling depressed and dealing with many negative thoughts, like many of us know. I specifically remember one night in particular. There was a very painful drive home, and I remember telling myself many negative thoughts like, Josh, you've ruined your life. You know, you've been addicted to this for the past year and things are only getting worse. You know, like all the good things that you had in life before this are now gone. Like, you don't even deserve those good things anyways. And I would even start to say some things to myself like, you know, this is just how things are now. And I'm never going to be able to achieve freedom. Like, if it wasn't for the escorts, it would be the massage parlors. Or if it wasn't that, it would be watching porn or masturbation or just chasing women with my extra time. Like, I always had that sexual escape. And to be honest, despite all of these thoughts being rooted in reality, I did not want to believe these thoughts. I just could not stand the thought of these things anymore. So I began to question why I believed these thoughts. And I found some very interesting answers. What I found was that these thoughts were all rooted in many bad and limiting beliefs that I had about myself. For example, I believed that freedom wasn't possible and that I was bad with women, so I had to go and act out with other ways. Now, I really didn't think too much about this realization until a couple days later when I had urges to go and act out again. There were many rationalizations that started to pop up. Like, I would tell myself, you know, I just need to get this out of my system. You know, this is going to be one last time. It's easier than getting a relationship. I have to get my needs met. Like, all these rationalizations were coming up. The thing is, I want you to notice something. These rationalizations were rooted in the same limiting beliefs that I had a couple days ago. Those being that I believed freedom wasn't possible and that I didn't have the ability to be good with women. And I share this story with you today to show you that if you do not dig below the surface and ask the right questions, you are missing out on discovering the most important piece of data that you can leverage within your recovery that's going to allow you to go from fighting against your own body, just resisting urges and just battling, to actually solving the root problem and starting to work with your body instead of against it. You're not going to learn this anywhere else, so let's dive in. To better illustrate how you can identify the root problem, I created a graphic for you. This graphic shows the progression of what happens when we get tempted. And it all starts with a temptation. No, this is like the fuel for the entire system. This is the catalyst. And this can start by, you know, seeing a lustful image, you know, having a fantasy, getting triggered, having an intrusive thought, whatever. And this is the input that starts the whole system. And from here, the urge is filtered through everything that follows here in the yellow. Now, think of it like a filtration system, right? You have a water source, and in our case, this is going to represent the sexual energy or the urge. And that urge is going to get filtered through these five filters. And if everything is in order, there aren't any leaks, then the system's going to bear good fruit. You know, you'll get positive results. You'll get clean, pure drinking water. But if any of these filters breaks, not only is that filter corrupted, but it also breaks the entire system after it. And you're going to get bad fruits. You're going to get unclean water. So with that in mind, let's take a look at how this looks with your recovery. You know, I think most guys can easily identify that there's something broken in the system. However, their diagnosis of that problem is often incorrect. They say to themselves, I'm addicted to escorts, or I must stop myself from watching porn or seeing escorts. And they identify those negative actions as the core problem, which makes a lot of sense because that's the most visible part of the acting out process. And there's a lot of pain involved in it. And since most guys understand that our actions have consequences, they inherently understand what the chart says. You know, like, they understand if you take negative actions, like going on bad websites or calling up an escort or going on a campsite, like whatever that might be, that's going to produce bad results. They understand that inherently. However, a big problem that I see is that that self-diagnosis ends right there. The man believes that the root of the problem is that he takes negative actions. He goes and watches porn. He goes to massage parlors. He goes and calls and texts escorts to set up appointments. You know, and he forever tries to fix how he can stop taking those negative actions, but it never works. This is because he's trying to stop the climax of a problem that has not been addressed. And I'm going to say that again because this is very important. If your interpretation of the problem is that you get all these crazy urges and you have to go and resist those urges because if you don't, you're going to go and act out and hurt yourself, you've already lost. You have not identified the root of the problem. So if the negative actions that you take are not the root problem, what is? And to answer that question, we must dig a little bit deeper and ask ourselves why. Why do I take these negative actions to go and act out? And what we're going to find is that we take those negative actions due to our negative feelings and negative thoughts. You know, most of the time, we want to go and act out because we're experiencing pain. This can literally be anything. This can be boredom, it can be stress, it can be loneliness, frustration, heartbreak, anything. You know, most guys have a select few negative emotions, or as I like to call them, pain agents, that when these pain agents are felt, there's an internal trigger for your body to use sex as a temporary painkiller. You can think of your acting out behavior as like a sexual escape. You know, I explain this more in depth in other videos, but if you want to continue to get closer and closer to the root problem, we have to continue to peel back these layers. So we're to keep pulling back. Many of our negative emotions that we have are often rooted in negative thoughts. For example, I've worked with many successful clients who were initially trapped by very intense negative thoughts. I remember one older gentleman would always tell himself, well, I'm going to hell anyways, so who cares if I go and see an escort? Another guy would have this recurring negative thought in his mind, and he would say to himself, I hate myself, I hate myself, I hate myself, I hate myself. And that would be repeated hundreds of times throughout the day. And just to pull from my own story that I mentioned in the intro, like I had so many negative thoughts as well. I would tell myself, Josh, you ruined your life. You're bad with women. You're sick. You know, you're a loser. And all these negative thoughts were like mantras that I lived by, and they're all self-fulfilling. And the thing is, even if you learn how to deal with urges and know how to deal with the pain agents that I just mentioned, if you still have these negative thoughts, you have not even come close to solving the root problem, because your identity and your beliefs are still rooted in lies and things that do not serve you. Which brings me to the real roots of the problem, which is our beliefs. Negative beliefs start the entire chain reaction, which leads to negative thoughts, which leads to negative feelings, which leads to negative actions, which leads to negative results. You know, if your beliefs are not fruitful, you'll continue to stay stuck. Now, the funny thing is, even if these beliefs are rooted in reality, you know, you cannot believe in it because it does not serve you. Those beliefs instead keep you stuck in this kind of weird little victim mentality where you feel like you're not in control and that you can't change things. Because when I was addicted, I believed that I was not able to keep a quality woman. I believe this due to years of experiences where women would show a lot of interest, they were very into me, and I would end up just squandering that opportunity. And despite this belief being rooted in some truth, because it didn't serve me, I could not entertain that belief. And funny enough, once I challenged that belief, I began getting much better results in my dating life. And the same is true with the belief that I had that freedom is impossible. Again, I had all this evidence, I had all this proof that this was a real belief and that this was true. Like, I was struggling with lust since I was 4. But since I exposed it as a lie, since I challenged it and I didn't put power into that belief, I discovered the truth that freedom really is possible. And I hope for many of you, this is starting to make a lot of sense. You know, before you were blind, you were just fighting temptations, fighting urges, but now you can really see everything that's going on under the surface. And the cool thing is, simply the awareness of this concept is going to give you so much leverage on your own recovery, because you know the root of the problem isn't the urges. You know why you want to go and escape. You know why you want to go and act out. And that is powerful. So now that you understand this concept, let's make it actionable for you. I'll give you a 3-step system to help you put this concept into action, but it only works when you see urges as opportunities. They are no longer, from here on out, they are no longer something that you should dread getting, because urges are literally opportunities to expose a lie and learn a truth. Because the process of recovery is slowly and consistently over time, leveraging urges to collect important data so we can unpack that data and not only help you stay clean, but also solve the root problem. And a lot of that data is understanding why we take negative actions, so we can understand why you have these negative feelings, so you can understand your negative thoughts and understand your negative beliefs, so you then can replace those negative beliefs with positive beliefs, so you can start a positive feedback loop where you experience positive thoughts, experience positive feelings, take positive actions, and get life-changing positive results. So with the mindset of viewing urges as opportunities, you can now implement the 3-step to success. You ready? The first step is awareness. You have to train that muscle inside of you to become aware of when you're getting an urge. And once this is done, you can move to the next step of just calmly asking yourself, hey man, you know, what's going on? You know, I have this urge to go and act out. Why do I want to go and act out? And you can see just from my tonality that this is done in a very loving way. A very understanding way. It's not something that you're trying to combat. You're not trying to fight yourself or change the way that you feel. You're trying to talk to it and understand it. And simply just by asking yourself these questions, you're going to become aware of the deeper problem. So once you do this, you can move on to step 2, which is understand. Like, have a conversation with yourself and dig a little bit deeper on why you feel the way that you do. You're going to find a lot of important data. And once you do that, you're going to be primed for step 3, which is create a compromise. The goal of this step is to kill 2 birds with 1 stone. You're going to use self-talk to talk yourself out of acting out and create a game plan on how you're going to solve the root problem. For example, let's say you realize that you want to go and act out because there's a pain agent of loneliness, a little bit of isolation, maybe some boredom. You realize there's a lot of negative emotions going on. So what you can say in that example would be, hey man, you know, I know you want to go and act out because you feel isolated, you feel a little lonely. So because of that, I'm not going to go and act out, because that's not what I really want. Because what I really want is some connection. So what I'm going to do is, instead of acting out, I'm just going to go outside the house for a little bit, and then I'm going to create a game plan on how I'm going to attend an exercise class tomorrow so I can feel connected, feel a little bit social. Like, that's just a simple example that I came up with the top of my head, but as you can see, this is a very simple solution. It's not really complicated. It gets to the core problem, you understand it, and you create a game plan, you create a compromise to stay clean and actually solve that root of the problem. It gives your body a way to express pain so it doesn't build up and build up and build up and you have this real intense desire to go and escape. And you have a way to stay clean because you're working with your body instead of just trying to white knuckle it and repress it. Now, do not let the simplicity fool you. This process takes time. It takes time to learn all of the data, and it takes even more time to change your beliefs and solve the root problem. And along the way, there's going to be a ton of resistance to go back to your old tendencies, with a lot of fear, a lot of uncertainty, a lot of challenges just to keep you in your comfort zone. And above all, you really need patience and accountability. So if this process sounds good to you and you want to work with me one-to-one to be able to identify all the root problems and the pain agents and really dig deep with someone who has done it themselves and achieved freedom and worked with dozens of clients who've done the same and learn how to make these compromises so you can stay clean without fighting and using willpower and actually solve the root problems so you can have freedom. Instead of struggling with this for the next 3 years, you can get this done in the next 3 weeks and be fully completed in the next 3 months. So if that sounds interesting to you and you know you need help with this and that you like my story, you like what I teach, click the link below and apply for the Recovery Blueprint Program. Your future self will thank you.